Hello everybody, my name is Michael, and in this video I want to talk about coming out. So to me, coming out in this sense and in this video is coming out as a non-cisgendered, non-heterosexual individual. So that might be coming out as gay, it might be coming out as trans, it might be coming out as asexual, non-gender binary, gender variant, queer, whatever. There are so many different identities that people have about themselves. So, coming out as non-hetero, non-cisgendered. Unfortunately, we live in a society where coming out is necessary because the default is hetero, cisgendered, at least. That's been my experience. I think that more and more now, the younger generations are being less binary about gender and sexuality. So that's great. I came out twice. The first time I came out as lesbian. That almost hurts me to say because I don't associate with being lesbian at all. But anyway, I like girls and not boys, so I came out then. And then the second time coming out as transgender. So, to me, coming out was necessary because I wanted to be honest with the people in my life, and I wanted them to stop asking me whether I had a boyfriend. I wanted them to stop calling me by my birth name, using female pronouns, and calling me chick or miss and all that kind of stuff. So coming out oftentimes becomes necessary because we feel like certain roles or identities are being imposed on us by others, and we actually want them to treat us differently. So how do we come out? I remember when I was coming out as lesbian, and a lot of times it would just being like, I had a partner at the time, so I would just say like, "Oh, say my partner's name is Mary. It's not. Oh, I have a girlfriend. Her name's Mary." Or saying like, "Mary and I, went grocery shopping." Or how people talk about their spouses. I was just talking about my partner, and let people make their own conclusions. Or sometimes they'd ask me like, "Wait, when you say girlfriend, do you mean girlfriend or girlfriend?" I've always wanted to be informal about coming out. I didn't feel the need to have a sit down, I need to tell you something, I hope you still love me type conversation. 'Cause I think that's what it used to be like for a lot of people, and because it was a much bigger deal before than it is now, so I'm grateful that I can be informal about it and people are aware of what I mean. So the first person I came out to was my partner, and that was before I even knew or I'd come to terms with being trans. Then it was coming out to my closest friends. Similar thing, I hadn't come to terms yet, but I wanted to share with them that I didn't want them to call me chick or miss, or I wanted them to use a shortened version of my birth name, which was more androgynous. And that really helped me feel more comfortable and make safer spaces and more comfortable spaces for myself with my friends. So a bit of background history. Well, at the time I lived with my partner. I live in a different province from my family. I work in a very large organization. We have buildings across the country, and I had been there for 7 years, so a lot of people in the building knew me. I work with 300 to 1,000 people in my building, and we actually have buildings, other buildings in the city where sometimes people switch back and forth, so I have a lot of coworkers. I came out in a lot of different ways. I came out to my siblings over the phone or Facebook chat simply because I see my family once a year, and I wanted to tell them. I didn't want to tell them while I was there with them, in case they weren't okay or it got weird, I wanted to make the most out of my trips visiting my family, so I wanted to tell them before that over the phone or whatever. I told my parents over the phone. At work, I started telling my close friends. I would tell them that I didn't want to tell them anybody else, but I would write on a little post-it note, my new name is Michael, or I'm going to change my name to Michael, or something like that, and I would just show them the post-it. And I'd say something like, I gotta tell you something. Kind of like something happened at work, kind of rumor type, I gotta tell you something. And most of them were great. They're like, oh, wow, okay. And I'd be like, don't tell anybody, but I want you to know. Coming out at work was almost more a logistics issue than anything else, because I do work with so many people. So I had a conversation with my manager, and, you know, we talked about washrooms and changing my name on my email and how were we going to tell everybody. She said, do you want me to tell people? Do you want your team leader to tell people? Do you want to have a counselor come in and then tell them? And I said, no, I want to tell people myself. I felt more comfortable with that, and it was important to me to tell people myself, so that's what we had decided. I know that someone in another building came out by staying home one day, or it was her day off. There was a team meeting, and the supervisor told everybody. There was a counselor there to answer any questions. That's what that individual felt more comfortable like. And then when they came in, it was, you know, kind of a reunion between her and her coworkers. So that's another option. I know that for people that work in a smaller workplace, like if you only have a dozen coworkers, it might be different. It might be you telling them individually or sending everybody an email or something like that. But that wasn't really appropriate for me, where I work with so many people. So I just had meetings with three of the teams that I work closely with, and then just allowed people to tell each other, really. I also used Facebook, the beauty of social media. I created a new Facebook account with my new name, put up a profile picture of myself, and then just started sending friend requests to my friends. Especially friends from back home that hadn't seen me in a while, or coworkers of mine that are friends, but I don't work with them directly. And I also use Facebook to come out to the volunteer organization that I'm a part of, which has around 80 members. I had told a few people beforehand, people that I'm closest to, but the majority of them found out through Facebook or word of mouth. So, and now I'm still coming out. You know, I'm coming out to people that I work with that I hadn't seen in a long time that somehow hadn't heard, and they'll run into me and they'll use my old name, and they'll be like, oh, actually it's Michael now. That's usually how I tell people in those kind of situations. And I remember one lady in particular, her face was kind of blank, and then I saw, you know, her processing of that, and she's like, oh, okay, okay. And the most common question I get, which is what she asked, was why did I pick Michael as my new name, which is a pretty awesome question. Coming out is a lot easier now than it used to be. For example, I'm a blood donor, and they usually call me to set up appointments, and they called me a few days ago, and she asked for my birth name, because I haven't legally changed my name yet, and I said, yeah, it's me, but I said, it's Michael now. I'd like for you to call me Michael. And most people are pretty receptive to that. I'm very lucky that I live in a place where it's not an issue. So my dentist, for example, I say, you know, I want you to put on file that I want to be called Michael. I went for blood work not too long ago, and I told the receptionist, I said, make sure that they call out Michael, not my birth name. She said, yeah, that's fine. She put it on a note there. There's no questioning. It's really awesome. And I have no advice for people that live in a place where it's not like that. I haven't personally experienced it, so I can't really share what that's like or how to deal with. Other than being polite about it as much as you can. I'll talk a bit more about that after. I know one thing that was important to me before coming out at work, especially, was having a group of close friends that knew about beforehand, because I knew that if somebody had questions, they might not come ask me directly, they might ask my friends. So it was important for my friends to know as much as I wanted them to know, so that they wouldn't feel like they couldn't answer people's questions if they had questions, or they were just there to support me. They knew they could offer me my support if someone was being disrespectful or whatever. What else? After coming out. So, as much as we would like to think that we come out to people, boom, it's done, we don't have to worry about it anymore, it's not like that. A lot of people that I told at work were upfront and said, it's going to take me a while to get used to your new name, or I'm going to slip up. And it's okay, I understand. I almost misgendered myself a few times and almost, like, answered the phone with my old name. So, I mean, it's only fair to be understanding and patient with the people in our lives after we come out, especially as trans. It's not an automatic switch for them. It wasn't an automatic switch for me. It took me a long time to come to terms with being trans. It's only fair that I allow them however long it takes them to come to terms with being, with me being trans. That might mean me distancing myself from someone until they're more respectful or okay with it, but I don't feel like it's fair for me to get angry or condescending or rude to someone just because they misgender me. And still correcting them when it's appropriate in a respectful way. And a lot of times I'm lucky, I'm very socially comfortable and I get along with a lot of people. So when some of my coworkers would misgender me by calling out by my old name, I'd be like, who are you talking to? And then they would realize and say, oh, I'm sorry. Or if they would say she, I would just be like he or something like that. And you know, trying to be as informal about it as possible, because they are going to slip up, and yeah, it really sucks and it makes me feel uncomfortable, but it happens, and it's not going to make anything better by me being an ass about it. So try to be patient. Same with my family. I don't know if my parents refer to me by my new name yet, and I came up to them last July. So I think it's one of the downfalls of not living there. They're not seeing me change, they're not getting to experience the new me. And so when I was there last October, my parents did not use my new name once. I was there for 2 weeks. So it was very, very draining for me, and I asked them formally. Mom said, she said, it's going to take me a long time. I said, I understand. I want you to try and explain why. And I even said to Mom, I said, because at that point I was almost 2 months on T, and I said, it's really uncomfortable when we're in public, especially because, I said, I'm being perceived as male and you are using my female birth name. And I said, it makes me uncomfortable and it makes me a bit afraid because I could be harassed or worse, violence could happen if I'm outed like that in public. So I think it helps our parents understand why it's important to us when we express those things to them. And at the same time, being understanding that for our parents especially, and especially if you're older like me, I'm 30 years old, my mother's been calling me by my name for that long. It takes a long time to get used to a new name. It took me a while to get used to my new name. So please be patient with the people in your life as much as you can. I can't think of anything else. I know it's hard, especially at first when you first start coming up to people, but try to be as confident about it as you can. When you're wishy-washy, people feel like you're not serious or you're not sure, and maybe you're not. I know I wasn't at first, but now the more I come out, the easier it is and the more confident I am about it, and people seem to respond better to that. So try your best to work on that if that's something that's difficult for you. Okay, my video is almost 60 minutes. Thank you very much, everybody, for watching my video. Again, if you have any specific things that you'd like for me to talk about, if you have any questions, please send me a message or leave a comment. And cheers! Happy coming out.